Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are about to do some cooking. I've had a few requests to do my cauliflower mash. So I figured I'm going to be meal prepping it for the week for me. So I figured I might as well show you guys how I do it. So easy. It's so good. I'm telling you, once you try it, you won't even miss eating mashed potatoes. So come on, let's get cooking.
Time to go there. Then you got the cauliflower, guys, and then we're just gonna put it in the pot, put it up, and yeah, that's how you make it.
Here is a head of cauliflower. All I'm gonna do is chop it up into chunks, which I'm not the best at this. It really doesn't matter how you cut it. You'll probably make a huge mess like I do. And all we do, throw it in our big pot. You're gonna need a big pot. I like to cut them a little smaller, but cut them how you want. Who am I to judge? All right, let's keep cutting. Cutting, cutting, cutting. You getting my cauliflower? Kayla's my camera woman today. Mm-hmm. Say hi, Kay. All right, see, guys? We're just chopping it up. I'm making a huge mess on the counter, but that's okay. What's a little mess, guys? What's a little mess? Can't waste any of that good cauliflower. Oh my God, Doobie is over here staring at me, guys. He's hoping I drop something.
Good boy.
Kayla, focus.
Oh, sorry.
Not on Doobie. See, guys, I'm just chopping it small because I find it cooks better. Doesn't take as long. So good. Get all this goodness off of here. Don't want to waste none. Thank you, Kayla. All right, guys, now that I just have my water, I cook mine on high until it starts to boil, and then I just lower it. So I have electric stove, so like 5 on medium. And believe me when I tell you, I cook it until it's over well done, because then it's just easier to mash. So we're gonna let this cook, and then I will come back and let you know exactly for how long that I boiled it for. See you in a bit. All right, guys, now I've drained my cauliflower. Make sure you drain it really well and get most of the water out, because you don't want a watery cauliflower mash. All right, put it back in our pot. Bring it back over to the stove. I'm gonna come on this side of me, okay? All I do then is, for a whole head of cauliflower, I use about a half a block of an 8-ounce container of cream cheese. So I use a half a block. I use a 1/4 cup of butter for a whole head of cauliflower. Again, you can make this recipe your own. You can add in however little, however much butter and cream cheese you want. I like mine super creamy. And also, I have a KitchenAid. A lot of times I'll make it in the KitchenAid, but you can also do it with your mashed potato thingy. And then, get it in there, Kay. You're just mashing like you would mashed potatoes. Are you steaming up my camera?
No.
And then, at this point, you can season it up to however you want. Hang on, I still have some mashing to go. Salt, pepper. Now this will thicken up a little bit as it cools, so don't get nervous if it seems like really runny. Steam it up. Look at how good that looks, you guys.
It's really steamy.
Tell me it doesn't look like real mashed potatoes. What are you doing, Kayla?
Focusing.
Oh. Hey. Let me get it. See you guys. So good. I'm like not even exaggerating how good this is. It needs a little more salt. I like a lot of pepper. Like mashed potatoes. Let's try another bite. It's hot. Bite for you guys. You guys, you see how simple this is to make. Let me know if you guys try this recipe. All right, guys, I guess that's it for today. You know how to make my cauliflower mash now. I want to thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you hit that like button. And honestly, if you want to see more cooking videos, put it in the comments below. I'll see what I can do. But all right, guys, thank you so much. Love yous.